Session, our educational session is about organizing your speech. How to organize your speech. So, what are the components of the speech? Anyone? What are the three basic components?
Introduction, body, conclusion.
So, it's intro, body, conclusion. So, every speech has an intro, body, so intro is where you tell them what you're going to tell them. Body is where you actually tell them. And conclusion is where you tell them what you told them. Right? So it's simply the same thing. It's tell them what you're going to tell them. Tell them. And conclude it, telling them what you have told. Intro and conclusion are the ones that remain with the audience. So we have to make sure that the intro is very interesting and it provokes the audience's interest. And we'll have another session on intro itself, but for basic tips, you can have your intro like asking a question so that everyone gets involved. Or starting it with something very interesting or giving some stats so that people get involved. So intros can be different. But today, so when you normally start, let me ask you, what is it that you focus on? Where do you start when you're starting your speech? What did you do here?
I try to make it a bit interesting, a bit captivating audience. Yeah.
So where did you start your speech? Well, where did you start thinking about it? Did you start about
which section?
Which section?
Can I start? The body.
Right. So that's usually the recommended one as well, that you start with the body because intro and conclusion will flow from it. Mm-hmm. So most of us, sometimes people tend to get caught up in making a very interesting intro. And that takes a lot of your time and you keep postponing the speeches just so that you can get a good intro. But the recommendation is start with the body. When you have the body, your intro and conclusion will also flow through. So, we'll talk about this in more detail, but let's just focus on intro and conclusion. So, intro, you speak about 30 seconds. Conclusion, 30 seconds. When you're doing a speech, there are different ways people do speeches. You can write it out in entirety, or you can write out only the intro, conclusion, and keep the body flexible. There are pros and cons of it, of different ways, but if you were to write down the entire speech, they say that if you forget one part, you tend to forget the rest as well. So it kind of builds on you. So recommendation is, remember your intro, write it word to word, so that, because intro has to be very strong, so practice it. Conclusion is what remains with the people, so the conclusion is your summary and a call to action. So you can write down that as well and practice and rehearse it, so that you ensure that the delivery of conclusion is very strong. Your body, body is where you can be flexible. So body, you talk about in the body the 3 points. So 3 is the magic number in Toastmasters. It's the three parts. Because 3 is what, psychologically also, we are very inclined towards. And I don't know, Benjamin, if you would agree or no, but
always very.
Yes. But 3 is the magic number in Toastmasters. So you can think of the 3 points that you're going to talk about. And then, now we've all got used to doing impromptu speeches. So based on those 3 points, you think about the pointers and during your speech itself, you can focus on or give impromptu about each of those 3 ideas. So that allows you to be flexible, that also allows you to use the word of the day, to use the 2 sentences in your speech and to modify your speech on the go. So you don't have to worry about writing an entire speech campaign in one go. So now, Benjamin, even if you have not organized your speech, as long as you have your intro, conclusion, you can do an impromptu of your body and think of the three main points you're going to talk about, and you'll give a good speech.
Yeah, I'm going to get it there.
So there is another, one of the ways of thinking about your speeches is mind mapping. And I don't know how many of you are aware about mind mapping, but I can just talk about it in short. So mind mapping is basically putting out there the ideas. I don't know if you are able to see it, hear me? You are? Okay. So mind mapping is where you put the main idea, say, what are you going to actually talk about? So you start with your idea. Let's just build a speech. So any idea on any topic? Anything?
I need more sleep.
Okay. Sleep is what we need to talk about. So what is the purpose of a speech? Objectives of why you need more sleep? So informing. Let's say this speech is about informing the audience why they need more sleep. So the purpose is inform. What are the things that we'll talk about as part of this? So we'll talk about the benefits of sleeping. You talk about the ill effects of sleepiness. We will give examples of and more than people.
So sleeping more than people.
Okay. The side effects of sleeping more than people. Yeah, so the effects of sleeping less, so sleep problems. So basically you have those three things and then you can add more to each of those three ideas. So now what you need for writing a speech is only an intro and a conclusion. An intro you can say start with, how many of you have had a good sleep last time? And you can start. You can give about, on these three topics, I'm sure you can just go ahead and talk about 1 to 2 minutes each. So, you can go ahead and say, these are the three things I'm going to talk about. The benefits of sleeping, the ill effects that people face, and if you were to sleep more, and just like acting in excess can be harmful, how can sleeping in excess can be harmful as well? And then you talk about it. And then you conclude with a call to action. So, as we talk, blah, blah, blah. That's why you need to sleep more. And that's it. So, that's an easy way of not fretting over creating a speech. Just go ahead, make sure you have the three things. You have a strong intro, strong conclusion, stay flexible with your body, keep the three things, and you have a good speech. So, as I say, while speaking, a public speaking is an art. The science of organizing it can make your life